One of the most important features we're missing in the phone book application is the possibility to change data. Actually, as you can see here on the screen, there is this highlight on the contact detail screen, and there's a warning here in the true change pane. Basically, what this is telling us is that we don't have any way to send the user inputs into the server. And we will fix this here in the contact detail screen by adding an element here into the form, which is a button. A button is a widget that allows you to make a request to the server and send the user inputs. In this case, we will send the contact to be updated in the database. So let me drag and drop the button here into the form, and I will place it right after the phone number input. And let me rename this button to save. Now, we have an error. We have a button in the screen, but we need to define what this button is going to do. And to define this, we need to create what is called a screen action. A screen action is just logic that runs on the server side when the button is pressed by the user. In this case, we will use it to update the contact information in the database. To create this screen action, we'll go here into the contact detail screen, right click, and add screen action. I'm going to call it save as well. And this is where we'll have the logic to update the contact in the database. But before we define this logic, let me just go back here into the screen, because I need to bind this action to this button here. So if I select the button, I'll need to fill in this destination property. And basically, this destination property is going to point to the save action we just created. Okay, so let's define the logic for this save action. Let me just open up here the screen action. And what we want to do is to send the contact information to the database to be updated. And to do this, we're going to use an action that you will find here in the data tab. Below the contact, you will find here a bunch of actions that allow you to manage this contact in the database. The one that we're going to use is this one, update contact. This is the action that we're going to use. The update entity action is an entity action that receives a record as an input parameter and updates that record in the database. So when we drag and drop this action here into the flow, we will need to define this source property. And basically, this source property is expecting to receive a contact. And we will get this contact from the form record property. Okay, the form record property holds the values that were entered by the end user when he updated the contact. So this one here. Just to finish up this logic here, what I want to do when I update the contact is to go back to the contacts list page. So I'm going to use another tool here. I'm going to use this destination tool that will redirect the user to the contacts web screen. Now we're almost done. I just want to complement this implementation here with a cancel button that will go back into the contact screen as well. So let me add here another button and let me label it as cancel. And in this case, the destination that we want to give to this button is not a screen action. It is the contacts web screen that we have here. Okay, so we're good to go. Let's publish and see our application in the browser. And here we have our contacts. Now we can navigate into Joanna Rivera, for instance. And let's update the phone number of Joanna. So let me say that this is not 201, this is 209, this is 229. And let me save it. We go back into the contact screen and the phone number is updated. All is okay. You can also navigate into Dwayne, for instance, and Well, I don't want to update anything. Let me just cancel here this operation and go back into the contact screen, and Duane contact information remains unchanged. That's it.